It's Retro Robbie coming at you with another pickup video. This pickup is extremely overdue. I've been meaning to always record this and I just forgot about it basically. As you can tell, there's a huge gap on my gaming shelf here. You typically would see a lot of box stuff there. Well, I got that back, like that haul, that the one I'm about to do right now, the pickup, I think it was November or December of 2011. Quick background story, I was probably talking off and on with this one person, like through a wanted ad that I had, like for about 6 months, that some items that her husband had. Apparently he used to own a convenience store that used to rent games. And a lot of them, he had like box protectors over the boxes when he kept it on the shelves for rental. So a lot of these boxes, like for the most part, are in really good shape. Not a lot of them have the manuals, some do. I didn't have that much money on me because I didn't expect to see this much, but I'm like, I only have 130 bucks on me, dude. He's like, you know what, I'll do 120. So very good buy. I'm gonna go through everything as best as I can. I traded some stuff over time, but in the picture at the end will show literally everything I got. First, some complete Genesis games. We got Sega Sports Deion Sanders Football, Sega Sports NHL All-Star Hockey, NBA Jam, NHL 95. It's actually a fun game, Hit the Ice, and Earthworm Jim. Got some random just empty PS1 game cases, Resident Evil, Black Label Metal Gear Solid, Black Label Final Fantasy VII, and as I said, these are just the cases, and just a really messed up case for Red Alert Retaliation. Also some loose cartridges. We got Out of This World for Super Nintendo, and Bubsy. And some loose N64 cartridges, Mickey's USA Speedway, Vigilante 8, and a very expensive game right now, Super Smash Bros. As I said, there's a lot of box games. It's just Super Nintendo and N64 games. The first set I'm going to show you here that are still in box protectors are just the boxes. Some have manuals. All of them have the cardboard inserts, though. So we've got Blast Corps. Also, a lot of these games, almost all of them, I've filled with loose cartridges I've had by now, like that I've found over time. MRC Multi-Championship Racing, Mission Impossible, Earthworm Jim 3, 007 World Is Not Enough. There will be some duplicates in here for sure. South Park Chef's Love Shack, Flying Dragon, cool fighting game actually. Extreme G, good one here. Banjo-Kazooie. All these boxes, for the most part, are in excellent condition because they've always had the box protector on them. A little bit of fading on a lot of them, though. Mace, The Dark Age. Bass Hunter 64. 1080 Snowboarding. Quake 2. GoldenEye 007. Classic greatness right there. Pilotwing 64. Duke Nukem 0 Hour. Rush 2. San Francisco Rush, Extreme Racing, Star Fox 64, amazing game, Forsaken 64, interesting cover art on that one, Diddy Kong Racing, two really good ones here, Snowboard Kids, and yes, Snowboard Kids 2, and I've already filled those with loose cartridges, and one Super Nintendo game that was just the box, Mega Man X. Very happy to see that. Even though it's the most common of the Super Nintendo Mega Man games, still not easy to find, that easy to find even loose. So when I saw this box, I was really happy because I had a loose cart to fill it with. Okay, now, these are all games that came with the cartridges as well. Like I said, some with manuals, some not. Got Dennis the Menace. Got two Fatal Fury specials. Strike Gunner, Skiing and Snowboarding, Tommy Moe's Winter, Extreme, Suzuki 8 Hours, Bulls vs. Blazers, F1 Pole Position, Big Sky Trooper. A lot of these games too have went up a lot in value since I've got them, especially in box. Mitsume, Championship Wrestling, really good company, makes some amazing games. Wheel of Fortune, Venom Spider-Man Separation Anxiety, ESPN National Hockey Night, Shaq Fu, NHL 95, I'm in Canada, so I remember as soon as the NHL games were coming out, everybody was all over it. 96 was my favorite, though. Most people like 94 the most, but I really like 96. We got FIFA 96 soccer. Many box games. Wayne Gretzky and the NHLPA All-Stars. Batman Forever. F1 Rock 2 Racing Race of Champions. NBA Jam. So many. Super Eagle Strike. Breakthrough. Jack Nicklaus Golf. NBA Live 96. Stunt Race FX. This one, the controls I find kind of annoying. Total Carnage. Brawl Brothers. Got Mortal Kombat 3. Okay. Now it's time for the N64 ones. So, NFL Blitz. I remember I played this so much on the PS1. Automobili Lamborghini. Another 007 World's Not Enough. Carmageddon. Really fun. Kobe Bryant in NBA Courtside. WWF Attitude. I thought these games were really good at first, but then when stuff like WrestleMania 2000 and No Mercy came out, like these, I couldn't even handle to play these anymore. Those suck compared to those games. I still think those are the best wrestling games ever made. WrestleMania 2000, No Mercy, WCW Revenge, games like that. Cyber Tiger. I know there was two of these because I did trade one off. PGA European Tour. There was two of these. Two WCW Mayhems. Two ECW Hardcore Revolution. Got RVD on the cover there. War Gods. This was kind of before everybody was looking for games. Now there's just so many people looking, like this would have been snatched really fast. Maybe not though, it was through a Wanted ad, right? But I was one of few people in my area with Wanted ads. I don't think anybody had them back then. So I scored in the early years because I started collecting in 09. But now it's really tough. It's like a race. But anyways, this is my favorite wrestling game of all time. WWF No Mercy. I think you don't even have to be a wrestling fan to like those games, I don't think. We got Milo's Astro Lanes. Jet Force Gemini. Knife Edge Nose Gunner. Castlevania. One of my favorite games of all time right here. Not so much to play on this console, but I mean, still one of my favorite games of all time. Resident Evil 2. Couldn't even tell you how many times I played through that on the PS1. Got the Mortal Kombat Trilogy. Two Pokemon Snaps. Quest 64. Super Mario 64. Classic greatness right there. Shadows of the Empire. I got two of these. I remember I went the PS1 route after Super Nintendo. I'm like, oh, I'm going to get a PS1. I don't know why, but we took that route. But we still wanted to play the N64. I remember Roger's video. They were renting the systems, and my dad rented me and my brother's system, and it came with three games with the rental. It was Shadows of the Empire, Mario 64, and Doom 64. So I guess those were probably launch titles, maybe not, or really early releases. Well, obviously Mario 64 was a launch, but I remember playing Star Wars the most. I thought it was a really cool game, and I still do. Banjo-Kazooie, two Kirby Crystal Shards, Buck Bumble. We got Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask Collector's Edition. Collector's Edition's more common than the regular edition, though, to be completely honest. But really nice condition box. Yoshi's Story. Pokemon Stadium. Big box. Okay, these last two are quite rare in the box for sure. The last one is extremely expensive these days, complete. So we got StarCraft 64. Most people didn't even know this game existed, to be honest. And the very last one, I put a box protector on this one because I just want to keep it in good condition. But this is definitely the best find of the whole thing. Worms Armageddon. Complete in the box, really nice condition. So yeah, guys, that's probably a long video. If you sat through it all, thanks very much. If you liked the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. I totally appreciate that. If you're new to my channel, please subscribe. Leave a comment. Let me know what you thought of this insane haul for the $120 price tag. And thank you for watching.